With the publication of our plumber add-in or complement for Revit 2020, you will be able to carry out real hydraulic designs and calculations in water supply installations in buildings. You only need a previously created piping system in your project using, of course, the BIM objects that Revit includes, such as fittings, pipes, and plumbing fixtures, among others, to be able, with a quick configuration, to execute the calculation and detailed hydraulic design. Once you have installed the add-in, you can see the plumber tab on the Revit's ribbon. And within it, you will find three panels to carry out the configuration mentioned above, the calculation, and the presentation of the results as annotations. Also, the results tables can be exported to Microsoft Excel files. In this way, to use it, the first step is to make the configuration through the options that you find in this panel. These options allow you to assign the type of text to use in labels and nodes, as well as define the units for data and results when you use the add-in commands. Then you will see the Sanitary Fixtures Manager. Here you will find the list of Revit families within the plumbing fixtures category so that you can, using the Hunter method, specify for them the fixtures units, type of fixture, that is, tank or flush valve, and the minimum regulatory operating pressure. Like our Plumber standalone program, when you press this button, you find the dialog to define the relationship between these fixture units and the corresponding flow, depending on the type of fixture. The next configuration to be made is the one relative to the diameters you use in the Revit model. Here, for each existing pipe segment, you must specify the friction coefficient to be used in the head losses calculation. Of course, two methods are available to choose from for this calculation. And, for the add-in's automatic design, that is, the determination of diameters in each pipe section, you also have two options. In the case of calculating the fitting's localized head losses, you have this button in the add-in settings. Here you can choose between two of the most used methods in plumbing design. The simplest, increase the length of straight pipe by a percentage that you will specify here. And the most complex, if you like, the one of the equivalent length. In this case, the configuration requires you to assign the type of hydraulic fittings, with each Revit object, in the pipe fittings and pipe accessories categories from this dialog. You see that, for each add-in's included accessories, you can specify the corresponding equivalent length that will be used in the fine calculation of the localized head losses for these fittings. Later, if the model created in Revit includes mechanical or special equipment such as water heaters, water meters, or pressure-reducing valves, you must use the equipment assignment option by pressing this button. Here you must indicate which Revit objects must be considered, from the hydraulic point of view, as special equipment. For example, since the heater is an element that interconnects cold and hot water systems has to be assigned. In this example we want to see the effect that a water meter has on the resulting pressures in the piping system. So for this object, I assign the add-in's meter equipment. The shutoff valves, since they are always open, are not of interest here since their head losses are supposed to be calculated with what we specified in the fittings dialog. So I keep them as unassigned so they are not taken into account in this case. Also, This network has a pressure-reducing valve that we will need to assign as such in the add-in. Thus, its pressure setting will be taken into account in the hydraulic calculation to be performed. With these buttons, you can define the selection and calculation properties of water meters and pressure-reducing valves. For meters, the nominal flow rates for diameter selection, as well as the method to be used to calculate their head losses. For pressure-reducing valves, we have here maximum flows per diameter, as a selection tool. And, since it is a particular characteristic of each accessory, from the drawing, we select it and press this button to see its properties. In this case, the valve setting is 5 meters of head losses. So we have configured the add-in to interconnect, so to speak, with Revit, and then be able to perform the hydraulic calculation. So let's go to the next step, the calculation and design. When we click the Calculate button, this dialog appears. It will list the cold water piping systems that are available in the currently loaded Revit project. In this case, of course, we only have one, which is selected to perform the calculation. Here we have options to perform the calculation only, or to perform the calculation in the automatic design. With this configuration that I have here, when pressing the OK button, the pressure required at the system supply point will be calculated, of course, based on the operating pressure of its most unfavorable plumbing fixture. Also, it will be determined what is the necessary diameter in each pipe section to meet the design velocity that we specified in the diameters manager previously. So let's click to see what happens. The calculation is successful. To visually associate results with the network, numeric labels are created on each network's node, as you see here. We could see the results element by element. For example, for this pipe, I selected and hit the Properties button. We see that, although its diameter in the Revit model is 15 mm, the add-in has determined that one of 40 is necessary. But, if you prefer, it is better to see the results tables. For node 0, the piping system supply point, we have the required pressure to satisfy the operating pressures of the sanitary fixtures. Let's look at the section or pipes table. With section 1 to 2, which is the pressure-reducing valve, we see that the head loss corresponds to the 5 meters that we define as its settings. For the water meter, section 3 to 4, we see that a pressure drop of 5.66 meters is determined. And so for the remaining sections of the piping system. We also have the diameter calculation tables. And, if it is the case, the determination of the equivalent length of each section, indicating the fittings installed in it, with their respective calculation value. And finally, so that you can show these results in the drawing, there are the text annotations. For example, for pipes, Let's create the calculated diameter and length. So, as you can see, with the Plumber add-in for Revit, you have a tool that will allow you to calculate and design water supply networks in a more practical way and, without a doubt, adapting to the codes and calculation methods that we use in our countries.